can involve these guys. And scares me as much as one kid was taken care of.
What do you mean?
They killed him. Somebody killed him. They grabbed him from somewhere. They kidnapped him. They wouldn't stop.
Where did this take place at?
Sacramento.
And where was the boy from?
Sometimes I know.
What was his name?
Jeremy.
How do you know his name was Jeremy?
Because I asked him.
What year was this?
I can't hear you.
What time in 85?
About June.
And how did you get out? And what city were you in now in June 85?
Sacramento.
And how did you get to Sacramento?
A flu.
I mean, commercial or private?
Private.
And I'm trying not to skip around here, but who did you go out there with?
I went over that time by myself.
In a private plane? They chartered a private plane just for you, yourself?
No, I was the only kid that went.
Well, who were?
Larry Sheen.
Just you and Larry?
Larry Sheen and me. It was just a small plane. Generally, it was just a single one. I made several stops on the way out there.
And where did the plane, where did you depart from?
That plane was from. We landed. It was from,
Did you leave from the commercial airline side or from the other side of the airport?
From the other side.
Do you remember,
It was from, I remember. And then we stopped in Grand Island, Denver. Then we stopped in Nevada.
Why would you stop in Grand Island?
Pick up some stuff.
What do you mean, pick up stuff?
We picked up some camera equipment and stuff. Then we stopped in Denver and picked up some other kid.
Do you remember where you stopped in Grand Island?
We stopped at the airport and we got out and we got it.
Did you take a cab or what?
No. Some guy picked us up in our van. Someone took us in his own house and picked up some equipment. Went back to the airport for the airplane.
You remember who the pilot was?
No.
And then you went to Denver from Grand Island, is that right?
Yeah.
And what did you do when you got to Denver?
We went into a bar. And then you picked up the kid there.
Was the kid already at the airport?
No. We went to a house, we picked him up.
What was his name?
Nicholas.
And how old was he?
He was about 13.
Do you remember where the house was in Aurora?
I think so.
Okay. All right, so then, what was the purpose of picking up Nicholas?
Because he was going to take him up with us.
Okay, go ahead. Keep going.
After that, we flew and stopped in Nevada.
Where in Nevada?
Las Vegas.
Okay, and how long were you there?
Just enough to, I guess, refuel them.
Scratch? Did you pick up anybody else there?
No.
Go ahead.
Then after that, we flew to Sacramento. And then I met some little Italian guy who was supposed to be some kind of producer.
I can't hear you.
Not a murder, not a producer.
Why is that?
Because he's the one that wanted his kid to kill.
Well, could you be a little more, be a little bit more specific?
Well, I mean, it's, I think they were picked up in Denver.
You have to speak
and
up.
And they forced us to have sex with this kid, who we didn't even know what they were planning to do with us.
You and which kid now?
The kid that's from Denver.
Okay. They had you two do what?
Have sex with the boy that kidnapped. And they were filming this at a time when they told us just to do whatever we wanted and stuff. And so it was all just, everything that he was saying was that it was all just part of the whole thing.
All right, now how old was this boy that was kidnapped?
About 12.
And how do you know he was kidnapped?
Because they told us.
Who told you?
They were Italian guy that was filming.
Well, why would you believe that what he told you was true? Did the boy say that he was kidnapped?
All brothers doing was crying. And telling us to not hurt him, to nobody hurt him.
Was he used to having sex?
No.
Did he call out for his mom and dad? I mean, what? Tell me. Get detailed with me then.
No, he generally told us to just go. He challenged us to go. I have another
person. What? Who is where?
Where?
Which is where? Take your time. Take your time.
Put us in a cage.
Are you in a house or are you in a hotel?
We were there. We were inside of the building. Outside the woods.
Okay, let me back up. You arrived in Sacramento.
Yeah.
Where did you go when you got there?
We went to the hotel.
Okay, when you say we,
that's not the team, the boy, me, and Jack Fluister.
Okay, do you remember what hotel?
No.
Okay, do you remember what year?
It was 1985.
Yeah, what month do you remember? Yeah, you need to look at the 85 calendar right there.
I was 18 at the time.
Okay. All right. So you go to a hotel. Just take me all the way through it now.
So we got off the plane, we went to the hotel, we checked in, put all of our stuff in our room, and then we got on the phone and we called somebody in the hotel to be there and they to pick us up and take us back to somewhere and have a whole conversation. And then about a half hour later, some guy came up, knocked on the door and stuff, and we went out and got into big stretch limo that was there to pick us up and went out. And we drove about a half hour, 45 minutes, and we drove outside the city limits, and we drove into a kind of a treed area. A lot of trees.
Weren't you scared?
No.
You weren't scared?
I wasn't scared because I was scared until after I got there.
What about Nicholas? Was he scared?
Yeah.
Why didn't you guys leave? Why didn't you guys run? You had opportunity to leave, didn't you?
Yeah.
Why didn't you go tell somebody?
I didn't know what was going on until we got there.
Well, but you, I mean, when you... Okay, go ahead.
Once we got there, we didn't know what was going on. We got there and they told us they were filming, they're just going to make a movie. And I've already been in out there about 3 dozen times. We got filming movies, had accepted guys or other boys and stuff.
Same place?
Same. One time I was in the same place.
Same producer?
No. And I didn't think anything bad works, nothing ever gone wrong before. Nothing like this anymore. And when they started this planning, and they started telling us what to say and what to do.
Who would pay
what to do? This time guy, he gave us his lines and stuff. He said, nothing left to do is say what you feel. Practice is, he wants it to be, look natural, and something you. So just go with what you feel. So I just want to, get you guys filming, here. And they gave us these things like how the Tarzan works, They had him in the cage and stuff.
Yeah, who would you say?
A kid. That came out.
Was he crying? Yeah. At that point? That's all he did was cry the whole time? They didn't knock. Did anybody ever slap him and tell him to quit crying?
Yeah, they slapped him a lot.
And did he quit crying?
He started to, and then I started talking to him. And thought it was going to be alright, and that we weren't, nobody's going to hurt him. I tried to tell him nobody was going to hurt him. But he never believed me. And after a while, I didn't believe him. They had us, they took him out of the cage and stuff, and they let him run. We were supposed to chase him down.
How big of a cage were you?
It was probably about 5 by 5 feet.
So it was just a small cage?
It was a small cage.
And when you say we, who are you talking about?
We were the only other kid. Remember.
Nicholas?
Nicholas. They let him out of the cage.
Yeah, how many people were present?
It was me, Nicholas, the boy, Larry King, the pilot.
Pilot was there too?
The pilot was there too. Producer, and there was about 4 other people there that were filming this. And what they had us do is they had their camera set up so they let him out so he could run. They had us chase him down. They told us what we chase him down, we were supposed to chase him down, and then we were supposed to drag him back. We were both bigger than he was to run. And so we drug him down after we started running. We dragged him around and stuff.
How far did you chase him?
About 20 feet.
That's it?
It wasn't that fast.
Okay, so you caught him, and what did you do, knock him down or what?
Knocked him down and drug him back up to where the cage is at and stuff.
How did you drag him?
I grabbed his legs and then he grabbed his arms and just sort of kind of carried him back up and dragged him over.
Was he kicking, screaming?
He was kicking and screaming. And
what was he saying?
Saying, please don't hurt me.
Did you hear him call? Did you hear him call? What'd you do to him, Paul?
Huh? I did not tell him to do it.
What did they say to do before?
I said something.
Okay. Now you were used to having sex with people, right? Something else must have happened then when it fell.
He's trying to do something. just crying so much after dinner, they opened the case, they grabbed Nicholas, and they scared me to death, they took him and they drug him over into the woods and stuff, I heard a couple of shots. I thought they killed him too. They didn't.
They brought Nicholas out of the cage, and they drug him over to the, to where?
Drug him off into some trees or something. I thought they'd shot him, but they didn't. And they said that he came back, and then one day I came back, and he did those to come back and stuff. I didn't see him until about an hour later. They had him cuffed up. He was scared to death.
What did they do with the body?
I don't know.
Did you grab him away?
I started picking up him. Put it in the car. I saw a car drive away. I thought,
what did Larry King do for all of this?
He was watching. Smiling.
Smiling. Why didn't you report that?
Scared.
You never told anybody until this day about that?
Told my friends about it.
Tell the police about it?
Mm-hmm.
Who's telling the police?
Detective Pope.
What did he say?
He didn't believe me.
Why?
So those type of things just don't happen. Just like he says that this type of stuff doesn't happen in Omaha. Omaha was a nice conservative town.
You weren't in Omaha.
I know. But he's like everything else in this. But I tell him, this type of things don't happen in Omaha. People from Omaha don't do that stuff. That's a bunch of lies. We were just the same.
It happened to you, didn't it?
Yes.
So what happened after?
Much later, after the gunshot
and the boy was killed, did you leave?
3 hours.
Describe the setting for me, please.
Ordinary was a third. It looked like there was a garden off to one direction. There was a house that was not too far from there that I believe that the producer or somebody lived in. That's what we moved after we left there. In this clearing there was some rocks and big boulders, like caves like set in between. They had like clubs there for us, like caveman clubs and stuff. And they had this picture of a couple of dinosaurs and stuff that were right there too. And the room that led up there was kind of a closed room, and all the trees were pretty big. A wooden area and a smooth, you know, little like pond or something down among the trails. At the house there was a swimming pool shaped like a kind of that half moon sort of shape.
Tell me a little more about the boy that was murdered.
He had blonde hair and brown eyes.
About how old was he?
Somewhere around 12. His brother was from Idaho.
And again, how do you know he was from Idaho?
Because that's what he had mentioned.
The boy himself? And did he have a first name?
All I think is there was something. I don't know.
Trying to
remember.
Did you say where in Idaho he's from?
No, he didn't let that out. You guys kept telling me to shut up. I was trying to talk to him. I was trying to calm him down. I was trying to tell him nothing was going to happen to him. Everything would be all right.
You ever experienced anything like that before?
No. Just the 84 of my best friend killed himself.
Pardon?
Just the 1984 of my best friend killed himself.
But I mean when somebody was murdered like that.
Not that I didn't see. Just that I've heard about.
Any other identifying features you can remember about the boy?
Yeah. Two thumbs, other two center part. Both thumbs in the back of his teeth, and he had braces.
The filling on the upper or lower?
On the upper.
And how do you remember that?
Because I remember when I was doing stuff in the song.
Did they make you beat him?
They tried to.
Did you?
Not really.
Well, what is that you not really?
I act like I was hitting him, but I really wasn't. The other martial arts had a whole bunch of this stuff, and I was just barely hit him and stuff.
Tell me this. You were in martial arts. Why didn't you use your martial arts against some of these other people?
I was scared. I didn't know what to do if I did. I mean, they had guns and I didn't.
You think Larry King knew who this boy was?
Yeah.
Why do you think he did?
Because he was the one responsible for bringing this out there.
Was he responsible for this other boy?
I don't know. Why is out there for killing something?
Was this boy already there when he got there?
Yes.
Whatever happened to Nicholas?
As far as I know, it is in Colorado still.
You remember his last name?
No.
You know how we could find him?
No, I hadn't heard from him.
When was the last time you heard from him?
That was it. Sometimes I've never seen him.
So after this incident took place and you left the area, where did you go?
Back to the hotel for the night and we flew back here.
Did the pilot take part in any sex?
Yes.
Well, tell me about it. I mean, did he out there or back here or
out there in the hotel room that night with me?
What was his name?
I remember.
Nothing you can recall?
All I know is he flies out of Flensburg. He's a pilot for an east tractor.
Is he still out there?
I think so. I believe so.
Do you remember a first name, anything? Can you describe him?
He was a tall kind of a brownish blonde hair. And
was he white or black?
White. He had one brown eye and one blue eye. He had a scar on his left arm right here and all the way down. So he had a surgery or something. He had a tattoo on his chest right here of an eagle. And he's always talking about the Air Force and stuff. He's talking about how he spent some of the Air Force and stuff. And he'd been in the Air Force for like 10 years or something. He was a captain or something. The pilot thing.
When's the last time you've seen him?
About 1986, I don't know. But the last time I went to the party, I had a nice party. And a lot of guys I never asked him to meet because I don't know, I just kind of feel like a prostitute. I never asked anybody to meet. Never really care as long as I got the money.
Didn't this incident with this boy bother you?
Yeah.
Did you still keep seeing?
No, I stopped seeing brothers and all the other. I mean, I didn't want anything to do with him again. I got away from all those people in April 1986.